Haven't checked what they got. Oh god. Two Deathbringers. They are charging! That's not what normally happens. Normally they just wait. Alright, poison is not gonna do anything here. Rustling Deathbring. Auf der gegnerischen Stadt müsste ein Zauber sein, der entweder seine eigene Produktion oder seine Stadtmoral hebt. Auf jeden Fall ein positiver, nicht militärischer. Ja, denke ich auch. So hat's ausgeschaut. Is there an AOW meter? I have no idea actually. But I don't know if there is enough multiplayer to really have a meter going. I don't know. Might be if you like play in a one-on-one or so, that you might have a meter, which is strong, which is not strong. I don't actually know. But maybe Bart Prothese can answer that better. He played it, this game much more than I do. So maybe he has the correct answer. Okay. How are we gonna do this? Do we wait? Wait. Fire weakness. Ooh, a lot of fire weakness. Aha. Killing? Shall we? Can we? No, we can't. No, we can't kill it. Oh, we can. Plus 3 damage. How much does it change? No, we can't. Mistakes. I played like 200 hours multiplayer when it first came out. Oh, okay. I don't know, but is it really so competitive? I don't know. Then you should answer the question and not ask it. Is there an AW? I don't know if there is an Age of Wonders. But every time a single battle went bad for someone, they would rage quit the game and you... Ah, that's annoying. Alright, yeah, then you have to really get a group of friends together or dedicated people who want to play with you. Otherwise, yeah, I can see that that will happen. But it's the same when you play like, I don't know, Europa Universalis or Civilization. When they lose one city, which is important, they would just rage quit. I had this experience a lot in Civilization. I don't know, I think it's very balanced. Haven't played it with... Alright, so we're gonna wait. Or do I wanna engage this one? But we will get flanked then. No, I don't wanna get flanked. Alright, let's wait. Ow. Ow. It was clear that that happens. They always hate the archers. Can I? Oh yeah. Fuck! Can I engage this one? Oh, that's good. Gonna engage those two. Alright. So this is gonna be... hard. Alright. Now it doesn't work for killing momentum. One down, but now it's the problem. He won't attack. Oh, he will retaliate. Yeah, I bought the DLCs, but I didn't really play it since it came out. I don't know what to do. I think I try healing. Go for nourishing meal. But he will attack one time. We might survive. Yeah. Go here. So he can't get through here without taking damage. Can we go further back? Let's go further back. Can he? No, he can't use the shadow step. That's good. One more. Oh, we're still in range. Fuck. I don't want to lose the archer. Especially now that he is a champion. Damn it. Please don't die. Here's the devs are done with Age of 103 and they're coming with some new thing. Yep, they are. They are. I follow closely like everything that Paradox Interactive is doing, and yeah, now that Triumph Studios joined forces with them, and they already pointed out that they are working on something. Yeah, I definitely would love that too. Another game of those. Alrighty. I don't like this here. We will take 2x damage, but we will survive. Alright, I think I need to help here. Oh wait, we can use the archers. 4 to 6. 6 to 8, we will take more damage. Ah. Kill this one. Yeah, he will kill our spider. We have to kill that one. Ah, I just hope we don't lose the serpent. Oh, we can defend. That's actually good. I think they made Age of Wonders 3 too shallow. There's no real depth because everyone wanted to pass basically. Nah, I think it's not focused for on like. Don't. Are they coming back? No, here lies. Okay, I got scared. Wonderful, you killed. Never mind, you don't kill. You are going to kill.
Yeah, and I level up.
I think that's it. Nice, we didn't lose anything. We lost a lot of damage, but we didn't lose anything. Awesome. Yeah, we lost a lot of health.
Age of Wonders 3 too shallow. I mean, there are so many mechanics in the game, but it just takes so long. Even like for multiplayer and so on.
I mean, it's even cool that they added, like the multiplayer is around, you could play with 8 people or so. Compare it to like Total War Warhammer 2, which is just out like a few months. And you only can play on a multiplayer campaign with 2 people. Not more. So you only can play a coop campaign. I think you can't even play against each other, just a coop. And yeah, that's shallow, I think. Because I want a Total War campaign where I can play with several people, like with Civilization, Europa Universalis, or something like that. Or Age of Wonders. Because I think that's really cool. Leggings. I think we already have something. So, yeah. I mean, when you have a dedicated group of friends or community or whatever, and yeah, I mean, you can even play on the Battle for Middle-earth map in Age of Wonders. There's a good mod. And just try to play the War of the Ring. And everybody has to slip in a role, for sure, to play it. But that's actually fun. That's actually something I want to do. But then you need, as I said, the dedicated players. That they don't step out of their roles and like, yeah, play it more of a role play. I think that's fun. Huh, Undead Slayer is good. We fought already so many undeads. But I'm talking about the lack of city building stuff or any real politics, it's pretty much just combat. Well, that's true. Yeah. But on the other hand, that's when I compare it to Total War. The diplomacy in Total War is also shit. in Civilization, the AI is shit. Real diplomacy and like politics you have in, yeah, in Paradox titles, or Europa Universalis, I'd say. Well, it's not really politics. Hearts of Iron would be one. But it's mainly World War, or just World War. The problem with politics, I think, and diplomacy is that it's so hard to program a good AI when compared playing with a player. I think that's really hard. Go down there. Okay, do we want to go down or explore more here? Ha! Check out. Hello? Oh! You meet the village of Hualunti. Antuli, not Hualunti. What's our alignment, by the way? We're very good. Are we good or bad orcs? I don't know yet. First, check out what how strong they are. Oh! I didn't want to do that. That was a misclick, but okay, we are at war with them now. So we have a new city. There are five here. Actually, let's kill them. So there are only three. We're not gonna use it, lose a unit. You seen the new Three Kingdoms skin? A Chinese dev team is making it. I saw it on Steam, I think. And it reminded me of Total War and those kind of games. But how are the ratings so far on Steam or Metacritic? Is it out yet? I don't know. Well, at least I saw it in the store, so it might soon be out. Boom. Ah, early access, okay. Have you tried it? Would be interesting. Ouch. Give me experience. Just gonna whip you. Here we go. Okay, they're all full. I mean, why is it so... Now it says experience. Oh, and champion 1. They can upgrade more. That's what you said before. Yeah, Meister 10. So can I go on to 10, right? Oh, I got it. Like what Bart Protesa said. So anyway, they have a lot of work to do on it still. Ah, okay. I'll wait. I like and prefer games that are more fleshed out. Have I ever played a game in early access? I was part of quite some betas, even Hearts of Iron 4 and stuff. Oh yeah, and I played Northgard in early access. That was good. I liked that. The cool game for several hours. Production increased by 40%, but it's pretty promising so far. The devs seem to really want to work with the community. Oh, that's cool. I might have to check it out. Thanks for pointing out. Master 14 was the most I was rich. Okay, nice. I don't know if it has a... I don't know either. Gonna see. We're gonna find out. If the game goes that long. Okay, we can auto-combat that. Holy shit, that was close! How much HP? One. I hate auto-combat. Auto-combat is so shitty. But in every game. Not only in Age of Wonders. In every game, auto-combat is bullshit. Wow, 1 HP. Lucky us. Okay, we got Tigrants. Do we gonna keep Tigrants? No, let's stay Orcish. Migrate to Orcs. Yes. Yes. Orcs. Auto camera is hit random, yeah. Especially when you have cavalry units, they always die. Because, I don't know, the commuter just rushes them forward. And then they get flanked or banged on by all the enemy units. While your infantry is lagging like somewhere, I don't know, 50 meters behind. It's painful. Okay, what did we just... Oh yeah, we were for seafaring, yeah. Let's go for druidry so we can use more spells. Okay, so we have a troops here. Now I want faster growing. Okay, so we have luck on this. Epic. Epic is really hard. Epic is epic. Mm-hmm. Did it say we... Actually, I want another settler. For here. Yes. You have Stellaris? Yes! Sure! Played a lot of Stellaris, I don't know how many hours, and I'm playing every Sunday we have, I stream Stellaris. And we play a co-op campaign so far, and we are already, actually I would say in the mid-game, I don't know. Mid-game crisis haven't started yet, but we are quite in the mid-game. Yes! A lot of Stellaris going on. Let's keep it simple. Let's go first here. And oh, they have explosive death, right? Yes, okay, we're not gonna do that. We have no ranged unit here. No. Do this one.
Stellaris is really, really good. Especially with the new update, they changed some...
It's more strategic, I love it. Much better than before. With the sectors you get one by after each other and not weirdly generating borders and stuff. Yeah, totally different game. But I really like it. With star bases, more important, more defense. It's more, it feels more like Star Wars. Like how would you imagine Star Wars? Where you have like those huge fortresses in this in the not sky, the space, defending. And even Death Star like units or buildings. Pretty good. I like how and what direction it's going. And let me tell you, it's not the end of the DLC, so there is gonna be a lot more stuff coming. Well, hell, I guess I have to make it for you now. Well, that would be cool. That would be really cool. Alright. Go for the old priest. I will wait one more turn. They have a spear. Yeah, let's wait one more turn. This one hurts, but let's just. Yeah. Yep. If the spider. Nice. Alright, okay. Web. Yo, come do that. That hurts. So you go here. Spit, you flank. Lucky, nice. You kill. Nice. And you kill. Ah, two levels. Awesome. Ha, thanks for the follow. In Stellaris, the mate I'm playing with, he's called Chao. He is playing as space dwarves, and I'm playing as... They're called Nirhagnol species. And yeah, they are... Not very nice, let's say this. But they're peaceful, but hate aliens. Other aliens. Oh yeah, nice damage. And yeah, but they don't go for aggressive expansion, just defensive. When you get attacked, that you like they fight off. You should put your Steam wishlist up. You wanna see the Steam wishlist? Let me show you. There's hell a lot in there. Hell a lot. 239 titles. Actually, I already own this game. Why do I have it on the wish list? I have it boxed here. But there's so much stuff in there. So you mean adding the Steam wish list on where? Via Streamlabs to the stream or in the tabs down there? Are they called tabs? I don't know, below the stream where you find all the information. No skin on scum will befriend my poor Stellaris ever. I mean, adding 240 wishlist titles might take a while. I don't know. Yeah, down in the bottom. It will be a long list. I might actually do it with a link. So you think if someone wants to see it, you see me stream it, so they could buy it to like buy it for me and I could stream, right? So that's the thought behind it. Yeah, we gotta level up! Fuck yeah, look at that. Vampire, spider, queenie. Queenie weenie. Oh yeah. So that's good. Back to healing. Took a lot of damage. I mean, I'm thinking about it. Yeah. All right. Level up. Inflict stun. Huh? We already have it. Stunning touch. Inflict stun. Where's the difference? Stunning touch is stronger. It has an 11. This one is an 8. I have seen other streams where the Steam wishlist is linked and it's just on one click thing like the Twitter and Facebook links. Ah, yeah. Okay. Actually, I think I can just use this link here, right? See? Copy page URL. Can you try it? If you click that one, do you see my wishlist then? Should work normally. Dragon Slayer party. Ooh, yeah! And after that, we're gonna go for Chain Lightning. Very good. Yeah. More ranged damage. I'm more likely to gift the game if I wanna see someone play. Yeah. Than to give money or cheering crap. Yeah. True. That I can understand that. That's actually really good. I haven't thought about it that way. I just added the donate button, like the tip button I have, I think, this week. Before I didn't have one. Because I don't bother about it any at all. I have a good job and I'm happy like it is. I just do this for fun. But I like the engagement you get. And some people come here and even ask me, like, where is your donate button? What's going on? And I don't know. It's a weird feeling at the beginning. Like, I'm already, I was already donating to channels, but it feels so different when you receive it for yourself, you know? It's hard to explain when you're streaming by yourself and you just get tip for you, what you do, like what you enjoy doing here. But it's a really great feeling. Yeah. Very, very cool feeling. Because it's like someone saying, hey, what you do here is cool, it's entertaining. Keep doing it, and then yeah, it boosts. Just it's a real boost. And if that's like a tip or a cheer or actually a game is even better. Just like you said, because then you have something. Damn, that's on my wish list. You already know. Ah, you would like playing that, and then you can stream it. Dominion's 4 Thrones of Agent is already outdated, they got part 5 now, lol. Yeah, that wishlist is pretty old, to be honest. And I have like, yeah, I can show you. There are so many games in my library I haven't played yet, so a few years back, like, I had a real problem, you could say. I was buying a lot of games, and I didn't play them yet, so that's why I stopped buying games, or like, most of the games. I bought a few years back much more games. Until I haven't really played, like until I haven't played them, then I will buy new ones. That was my plan, and so far it worked quite well. I mean, I bought Total War Warhammer a few weeks back, but I don't regret it. It's really good, really good game. Yeah, but there's so much in there I still want to play. That's why the wishlist is so big. Yeah, I always keep like playing the same, which are all of those Battle Brothers. When I don't know, sometimes when I'm hangovered, I just go on the computer, put some music on, and then just Battle Brothers. Dark Souls, yeah, I'm streaming Wednesday and Thursday. I'm streaming Dark Souls, and regret it most of the time. Oracle Universalis for sure. It's my most played game with close to 2,000 hours. Not taking into account League of Legends. I played that a lot. I have Endless Legends and all the DLCs, but I'm played it once yet. Yeah, I can feel you. Yeah, and those are Kingdom Come Deliverance. Oh yeah, that's I didn't buy it. Now I think it was 2 years ago, so I stopped back. I was backing it. You call it backing? Backing. Yeah, backing on Kickstarter. Yeah. So this one is gonna get a stream when I'm done with one playthrough. Dark Souls 3 is gonna get a stream. Twitch I wanna stream. And Warhammer are the next. But those are the next plans. And yes, Stellaris all the time. Dark Souls gone. Dark Souls 3 then. And we wanna see after that Age of Wonders playthrough. What we do next. I don't know yet. Alright, if we get this, all our units get an upgrade, right? I like that. Let's do it. Hentaluki has shrunk into an outpost. Okay. Uh-huh. Oh, because we changed the race. Yeah, and you lose a population for yeah, that makes sense. We changed from Tigran to Orcs. That's why we lost 200 population, I think it was on the right. Yeah. Brr-brr-brr. Alrighty, what do they have? I haven't checked. Oh, Bacha. He's strong. Let's do it. I think they're not even... Yeah, they're... That's so crazy. The Orc Razor Bow. I mean, oh yeah. No, they didn't get any melee strength, right? No. On level 1, or rank 1, their melee strike is 1 down, like... compared to the strongest starting melee unit from the goblins. That's crazy. Orc melee strength is awesome. But the archer strength early sucks. I don't like the Blight Doctor. Don't buy anything that's not sell for at least 50. Yeah. That's a good choice. And I don't also don't like pre-ordering anymore. I got so upset by Rome Total War 2 because it didn't work on my computer. Because it was so damn buggy. No chance. Keep it safe here. Or shall we just rush? No, I won't rush. Expect the Stellaris DLCs, yeah, same for me. And I buy all the Stellaris DLCs and the EU4 DLCs I also buy. I always get weak. Web, 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 web. Nice. Tank. Kill. More kill. More kill. Doing good. Very good. Oh, I always forget the war cry. Would deal more damage. Oh, the frozen aura. That looked cool.